Yes, I do genuinely believe what I said in the title of this video. My favorite character, in all of Stardust Crusaders, most well-known part of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, as well as the part with the most fan-favorite characters in the series, is Noriaki Kakyoin. I like him better than all the other characters in the part, more so than Polnareff in his dazzling silver chariot, Jotaro in his powerful Star Platinum, Joseph and his not-so-great Hermit Purple, Avdol in his underutilized and underdeveloped Magician's Red. Okay, maybe Part 3 doesn't have a lot of very great characters, especially when you consider all the one-dimensional enemy stand users they encounter along the way. However, my point still stands that a lot of people can't help but like this part, despite its myriad of problems due to its few memorable characters that it introduced to the series. Anyway, back to what I was saying about how my favorite character in Part 3 is Noriaki Kakyoin. I'm here to explain why I believe this character does not get a lot of the attention and love he deserves. Quick spoiler warning for Part 3 of JoJo Stardust Crusaders. If you have not finished the part, or have any intention to watch it in the future, please click off this video now, as I would hate to spoil this wonderful story for anybody else. I'm looking at you in particular, Eric. Are we all good now? Okay, good. Now I can get into the good stuff. Let me start off by saying that I know from an objective standpoint, Kakyoin is not a very well-written and developed character. I know that quite well, but I can't help but love this character. I only found that in retrospect that I come to appreciate Kakyoin. It was only after Kakyoin met his fate from Dio and the world that I saw the void he filled in the team, much like how it is in real life. We don't learn much about who he is and his backstory until he's about to meet his demise. And as much as I would love to chalk this up to some genius writing on Araki's part, trying to make us feel bad about how we neglected to learn about him and how he died too soon, I know it was not intended to be like that, and it was just something that Araki put in the last second to make his death feel just that much more impactful. Whether intentional or not, however, it still has the same effect on me. He always flew under my radar, as he was overshadowed by other characters like Polnareff. And so I think that putting his backstory at the end like this actually does him a service, as it works towards his character traits a little bit more when you think about it. He was always a very reserved kid who struggled to make friends. As his teacher says to his parents, it's not that the other kids don't want to be friends with him, it's just that he doesn't open up to them. His timid nature was most likely what led to him becoming even more closed off and developing his stand, Hierophant Green, which likes to hide in confined spaces away from anyone who can hurt him. This is why I've come to appreciate how his backstory is only told at the end. He flies mostly under the radar for the part. It wouldn't really make sense for him to get a ton of screen time like Polnareff, who always wants to be the center of attention. Once again, I can't say with much confidence that Araki intended for this to be the case, but it still has the same effect nonetheless. Now, this is where I'll fully admit where some of my personal bias comes into play, which I really shouldn't let happen, but here I am, about to do so. Kakyoin is my favorite Part 3 character because I feel I can actually kind of relate to him somewhat. Me also being a person who struggles with social anxiety and has trouble opening myself up to other people, I feel I can really resonate with him. There is no other character in the series that I can think of at the moment who I can really relate to like I can Kakyoin. He's an enigma in the series. Yes, he's not the best written objectively, but that's not gonna stop me from loving this stupid sherry-looking guy. Also, may I just add as an aside that without Kakyoin, we would have likely not gotten the cherry-looking scene and probably quite a few less JoJo fans. I know that video got shared a lot when Stardust Crusaders anime debuted, and it got a lot of people to wonder who the hell this stupid red-haired dude with his damn cherry is, but then again, that's beside the point. He only gets a few fights to participate in during Stardust Crusaders. Off the top of my head, I can only think of four or so fights that he plays a major role in. Disregarding his initial introduction in the school and his final fight with Dio, which we will get into more later, I actually think this really fits his character, because as I mentioned a moment prior, he's very timid, and would rather make someone else look good, and help them rather than himself. I think that's where a lot of his likable personality comes into play, as when you think about it, Kakyoin's motivations for assisting the Stardust Crusaders in the war against Dio are very selfless and admirable. He says at the start, after Jotaro extracts the flesh bud from his brain, that he will be joining them, and when asked why, he says something along the lines of, "I don't really know, I just want to." Whether or not Kakyoin knew he was doing it to repay Jotaro and the others due to his grateful and selfless personality, and just didn't want to get into it, or he genuinely did not know why he wanted to, his goal is all the same. He does this not for himself, but the ones he loves. That kind of personality, I believe, is one that people silently gravitate towards, and usually do not know how much of an important role they play until they're gone. This is why it seems like how in a lot of JoJo reaction videos, when they get to Kakyoin's death, they're not bawling their eyes out or anything, nor do they really not care about it. If Kakyoin was a better developed character, I believe his death would have made almost anyone tear up when combined with his personality. On the topic of his death, I would like to bring up the exact way he died. Kakyoin came up with his plan to use the 20-meter emerald splash whilst the team was contemplating aloud what his ability could possibly be. He successfully trapped Dio within his Hierophant Green's 20-meter emerald splash and pulled the trigger, firing everything he had at him. Suddenly then, he was blown back, as he wondered what Dio could have possibly done to bypass the 20-meter emerald splash. Once he finally realizes what Dio's ability is, he uses the last of his strength to pass his message to Joseph in the hopes of any chance of victory. Kakyoin died to uncover the world's ability, and because of him using his big boy cherry brain to uncover his ability, the Crusaders finally had a chance against him. Without Kakyoin, I feel I can say with confidence that they would have lost. Joseph would have been slaughtered from an ability he did not know, Jotaro would have never been able to uncover his Star Platinum's hidden ability, and Polnareff would have done what Polnareff does best and get into trouble. However, this time he would have nobody else to count on. Thus, Dio would claim victory and enact his plan for heaven along with Father Pucci, and take control of everything with nobody to stand in his way. So I guess through the transitive property, Kakyoin saved the universe. Recall what I said not too long ago. Kakyoin does this not for himself, but the ones he loves. I think this is a perfect conclusion to his character. Yes, of course I would have liked to see him survive, but in the end it makes the most sense for him to lose his life against the hands of the world. Is he a very well-written character? No. In the end, no matter how much I argue in his favor, I cannot with a good conscience say he is a well-written character. But do I care? No. Kakyoin's S tier. End of story. Hey guys, I just wanted to take a second at the end here to thank you for watching this video until the end. I kind of just started typing up this script on a whim during class when I was bored, but I think it turned out for the best. My argument and the script in general is all over the place, because as I said before, I'm new to this kind of video. It's pretty different from my normal kind of content I make on this channel. I'm still trying to find my style, and so I just decided to talk about my favorite series and my favorite character in Part 3 for a little bit. If this is your first video you're watching from me, I really want to sincerely thank you for supporting this tiny channel of mine with a humble 19 subscribers. I'm not going to ask you to subscribe or anything like that, because if you liked the content, you probably would have done so already. I do warn you, however, if you decide to check out my other content, I'm kind of all over the place right now, and the videos are probably going to be nothing like this one. Anyway, I've gone on for too long at the end here, so I'll let you go now. Hope you all have a great day, and that I get to see you again in another one of my videos. See y'all.